What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, and do you ever have the feeling something's going on right under your nose? So, I have done some stuff and things, and we're going to talk a lot about it today. I hope you guys are having a good day. This is the thing that I didn't know. Some teak wood from Armitage. Oh, look, he's done the whole thing here. This would be the teakwood log, the teakwood block, the teakwood stair, the teakwood slab, and the teakwood fence. And how much of it do I have? 6 teak saplings. Thank you, Armitage. It's very cool. Hopefully, maybe we'll check it out. Maybe that'll look cooler up top in the treehouse, which we got to work on too. But I've been really busy. If you didn't notice, the shop is much bigger now. It's much taller. Look, we have rooms. Just because I wanted to get this project done, and I didn't really have enough room for all the pipes. I had to move some piping up a little bit higher. So, the old storage array, remember I had talked about it needing to be upgraded? It's all torn down from the inside, and it needed to be upgraded because within just a couple of weeks, I had filled it, and I knew that I could have upgraded the chests and done something where I put all diamond chests in or whatever, but if I fill up iron chests in a week and a half, it isn't going to be something that's going to last or be long lasting. So I really wanted to try to get something that was long lasting. So this is what I've done. There's roughly, if you take a look here, this is 15, so that's 30 barrels, 15 long by 2, 30 barrels, 30, 60, 90, so roughly 100. 100, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Those are a little bit smaller. I would say 7, 8, around 900 to 1,000 barrels. And the idea was that I would kind of have a barrel for almost everything in the game. You know, almost anything that you would need. You know, so when we're doing storage, stuff like a bio generator, a still, a fermenter, you see I just only have one of those things. Or let's say, for instance, aqueous accumulator, I just got one. World anchor, I just got one. Those things I don't necessarily need to store, but a lot of everything else I wanted to have in storage. And so let me go ahead and grab, I wonder if any of these have anything in them. So let's go ahead and grab some silver ingots. And then here, storage input still in the same place. I think these will filter. Eggs don't and tin blocks don't. The output's still in the same place. She should be able to see, there they go. The silvery blocks, and they should come over here, I'm assuming. Yeah, they should drop right into here. So you see them come down through, they hit the sorting pipe, they hit the router, and right there, they are going into that barrel. So I ended up using these routers and relays, and they use the relays. Stupid slimes are stupid. Notice the frame rate drop. I'm going to talk about that in a second. I'm only getting about 20 frames per second right now. So I used buildcraft piping, routers, and filters. And the filters act as sort of a buffer. A router does work fairly quickly, but it only has one inventory slot. So the relays act as a buffer so that multiple items can hit the relay, and then they'll pump. Little technical difficulties there. So, so the relays act as a buffer for the router, and so that the multiple items can fill up inside of there. So I ended up using the buildcraft piping just because I didn't want to use Bluetricity. So there's a sorting machine that works in conjunction with the router, and Zul'jin, if you haven't checked it out, did a video on how that all works. Emergency mute. I didn't want to use the sorting machines because it requires Bluetricity, so I'd have to have a whole separate power system and hook it up and find room for it. So up here I would have to have built some sort of secondary power system, and Bluetricity is not super easy. The easiest way to use Bluetricity is to use, there is a solar panel system that integrates with it. But we're underground, we can't use solar. So I'd have to use thermopiles and make them float up here, and I just kind of wanted to save this space. I didn't want to have to use all the space or whatever, it wouldn't use all of it, but I would have obstructions here where I was kind of thinking it'd be nice to have a second floor on the shop, and it would be obstructed by these thermopiles. I could go underneath, but I've always tried to keep this open so that the passive rubber array will have lots of room, will have lots of room for slimes. So that's why I went with the Buildcraft piping. And it works really good. There's only one problem. When I look in this direction, I only get about 20 frames per second. When I look in this direction, my frame rate starts to go up. I move away right now, I start to get 30, 31, and it starts to pin. So there you go, 42, 37. Let's take a look and look over in this direction. You'll see it start dropping, 28, 25, 20. So you can see we get a humongous frame rate drop. And that's because basically, I used cans as holding places. We can talk about that in a second. But basically the reason for the frame rate drop is that there are 1,000 entities here. There's 1,000 entities. These guys are entities. So there's 1,000, I don't know if they count as an entity or what they count as, but it's all of these items that are showing. They cause lag. They cause me to have a frame rate drop. So I use these cans and I'll explain how that works to you. So the routers are not as smart as I would like. They're pretty smart, but they're not super smart. So if there's TNT moving into this array, this is TNT, and you can see that's TNT, that's industrial TNT there. It doesn't get a name. But say I put TNT in here and this is open, it'll actually, if I'm not mistaken, go to the open slot first. So the TNT will come down, instead of going into this barrel, it'll fill the open slot, and then it'll kind of bounce back and forth. So I had to use these cans as placeholders so that nothing would go into these barrels until they're assigned. So basically, you have to enter an item into the barrel to assign it that value, so that all the items will, when it hit the router, will go into that barrel. So all of these things, all of these items, all of these barrels, basically, because there's items in them, if there are no items in them, wouldn't have this problem, but because there are items in them, it causes lag. And the other thing about this system that I don't like is that there's no error checking. There's no... So, say I got a barrel right here. This barrel's got iron ingots in it, right? Now, it's got... It'll hold 64 stacks, and then it will be full. So if items come down into the system and say this is full, there's no error checking. So they'll hit the router, they won't be able to go anywhere, and they'll sit in here. Then they'll fill up the relay and that will become full. When the relay is full, it has items that it can't move, it will show a red light right here. I can simulate it for you. Let's go ahead and I'll show you kind of what it looks like here. Just do this and put some single items through the system. So you'll be able to see the light turn on. So I could visually see it, but then what will happen is that will be full, and then it when the relay is full, items will start bouncing in this pipe. So since this, see it light up, bam, it's lighting up, it's moving items. If it's full, it'll light up in that, it'll be in the active stage all the time. But so if the relay is full, items will come down into this pipe right here, this final iron pipe. Since there's no output, they'll bounce back and forth. They'll just bounce inside the iron pipe and fill up and fill up and fill up and fill up. So one of the whole points of doing this system and using the Ender Chest is so that I can AFK this storage system. So I can set my quarry, set my Ender Chest as the output for the quarry, and the items will automatically come into the storage system. They'll automatically get sorted. I won't have to do anything. It's completely automated. So if I do that and one of these barrels fills up, then we're gonna have a major problem. I won't be around. I might be hanging out. I might be working. Now I start to work these 10-hour days. So I might be gone for 10 or 11 hours or 12, not even notice that it's filled up, and it can cause a problem for the server. So then the solution was I could use extra dimensional storage upgrades on everything. So every single barrel in the system, I could add the extra dimensional storage upgrades to it, and then most likely we wouldn't run into a problem. But even still, I don't think I have anything that's close to 1,000, but even still, I mean, I don't think that would happen. But so extra dimensional storage upgrades and everything would be great. But then we come back to the problem that when I'm working here and recording and stuff, every time I look over at the system, I get frame rate lag. And it bugs me. I don't like it. And it causes problems for other people. Some other people that like aren't running Optifine and stuff like that, it causes a lot of frame rate lag for them, much more than it does for me. or say we have somebody that joins the server that doesn't have, you know, their computer's a little bit slower, it might cause a big problem for them. And I want people to be able to come and hang out in my shop. So basically, that means all of this has to be torn down and redesigned. So I have a lot of work to do in that regard. I want to make sure that I do a really good job. I want to make sure that the next time that I build this, it's completely well thought out, and everything is going to work. So what we'll end up most likely doing is I'll still have arrays similar to this, and I most likely will keep a couple of these barrel arrays, maybe two, maybe, yeah, I'm thinking maybe two. But what we're also going to do is we're going to add back into the system these chest systems too. So the chests will also have their place, and that really helps to small it down to decrease the size, because for instance, Ender Eye dust, I'm not gonna ever have a lot of that. You know, I'm trying to think of something where like over here, I think electrum ingots, I'm never gonna have a lot of electrum ingots. I'm never gonna have a ton of aluminum, not enough aluminum that I need a barrel for it, or clay bricks. But I can store those in a single chest and really, really decrease the size of the storage system. So I think that that's gonna be really cool to have. Now, there's some other stuff and things that have been going on the server. I'm pretty sure Zul'jin and Woolly Creeper have already released their videos of it, so you can check out their videos on their channels too. The links to their channels are down below, but I wanted to go ahead and show you guys this new device that's been created. Oh, it's Knights. So, a couple of new XP farming and resource farming tools that I think Armitage, Woolly Creeper, Zul'jin, and Bowman were over here working on, and they're pretty BA. So, let's go ahead and I'm going to show you guys this one. So it is a cow. I don't know what you call it. It's a cow farm, I guess. So the cows fall in there. And then you can see it killing them, cooking them, and the items get sucked up. I think it's not a deployer. I can't remember what that item's called, what that block's called. Let's go ahead and check it out over here at the Enderman farm. Maybe we can take a look. I don't think I can. I might not be able to right-click on it. Okay, it's a filter, pardon me. So, if you apply redstone signal to a filter, it will absorb or, like, suck up items in a 3x3 area around it. So, there's water streams pushing those cows to the center. They fall through the lava, catch on fire, hit fall damage, turn into cooked meat and leather, and then the filter absorbs those items and moves them into those two barrels right there. So then this is a pretty unbelievable device. So I hope that I might wait a couple days to put this video out so everybody else can get theirs done. I don't want to scoop them on it. It's just a really cool idea. So we have some buttons holding up some vines, some tier 5 spawners, we got creepers, pigmen, and skellies, and it's on a remote control activated by this pressure plate. Watch this, guys. It's ridiculous. Oh. What's going on? Are we having an issue? It looks like we may be having an issue. Uh-oh. For some reason, our turtles are not attacking. That is not the best. So I'm glad I got off of that. Let me go ahead and take a look at what's going on, and I'll be right back with you guys. So this is what it's supposed to look like, and it's fairly ridiculously unbelievable. All these guys come down in here. The turtles attack them. The XP gathers. You can gain it like so. And one of the neat things that you can do, grab yourself a couple of books right from this area. You can hit this enchanting table, go ahead and enchant the book, right? So then I got power 3. So they see there's a filter right there. You can just toss the book out in front of you while you're standing here. It gets absorbed, pushed into those chests. and then you can gather more XP. The amount of XP that it puts out, it's 30 levels in a very short period of time. It's extremely short. I've sat here for quite a while, and I think one time it bunched up a little bit. It does have a tendency to overproduce. It's just too efficient. Protection 3. So, really, really neat design. Really cool stuff. And just such a fun thing to do. You can kind of hang out on the side here a little bit. Gain your XPs. The remainders of the XPs. And then the useful items that these guys drop that we may want to save, all filter over into here. We've actually already got 6 stacks of wither skulls. Unbelievable stuff. So, thirdly, one of the last really cool devices. Let me see if we can get this to... We can get it to render in the upper area here. There we go. Render in for me, big guy. This is an Enderman farm. So... You can see we have some Enderman balls right there, and if I stand on this pressure plate, they'll start to spawn. You can kind of see them falling to their death there. And it takes a sec for it to get, I think, I don't know if it warms up. It looks like we got 2 to 4 to 6 spawning at a time. But so those guys end up coming down, falling to their death. So you can see there's one right there. I don't know if he's from the spawner or not. If there's no one in the area, it seems that they don't have any tendency to teleport away while they're falling. I have seen it happen. I have seen them teleport while falling, which is pretty... There you go. There's one right there. He teleported while falling. Oh, now he's really mad at me. Are you going to come over and mess with me? Or probably not. So, then those... You can see the... That's really annoying and loud. Could you stop? Could you stop yelling at me, please? So, obviously, it's pretty far away, but what they've used is this item tesseract. So, tesseracts are really interesting devices. Let me see here and show you what they are. So, you can see there's an energy tesseract liquid, an item tesseract, and you can move energy, liquid, or items. I don't know if it's interdimensionally. I think it may be interdimensionally, but at the very least, it's basically like a teleportation system. So the filters are grabbing the ender balls over there. There's a tesseract underneath. It's tuned to frequency 124. So is this one, and so thus the items move from that tesseract to this one. And we get balls. And it's really great. And I can tell you straight away that these are some not only just designed extremely well farms. Not only are these farms designed extremely well, they're also really useful for the server, and that's something that's just really cool. Oh, what do we got going on over here? Oh, golden boots. I have no idea what this is here for. Probably a build station. But really useful for the server. Very, very cool. Designed really well. You can't just flip them on and walk away, which is nice. That helps so that we reduce any sort of lag problems we might have if somebody forgot to shut them off. You got to stand on them to get them to work. But we got tons of books now. All sorts of really cool enchantments. So those are some cool things that those guys have been working on. In addition to, I've also been working on some pretty cool stuff and things. So, I'm trying to think of where I had stuck it. So, I worked on some soul shards. I got this vial sword, and I built the vial sword and put soul stealer 5 on it and sharpness 4. And I built chicken, cow, and pig tier 5 spawners. I had an idea before those guys started building their farm to do something as well for the spawn area. And I may still do it. I'm not sure exactly if I will or not. I think I'm going to talk to them. I don't want to step on anybody's feet. But I do want to build the farm site. I think it's going to provide a couple other things that we don't have. We don't really need the pig meat. But it would be cool because the farm I'm thinking of will double as an egg farm too. So we can use it for eggs. And the design that I'm thinking about, I actually got from Kip over on Ironcraft. So pretty cool stuff. But I got a lot of work to do, guys. So just want to thank Armitage for for leaving a cool present. Go ahead and check out his channel too. It's in the description. He does some awesome stuff. I'm going to redesign this bad boy. It's going to be pretty cool. I think when it's done, it's going to be better because with the sorting machines, they do have error checking. If there's something that's not working correctly, they will not take the item. So it's going to be a lot more of an intelligent design. And I think it'll be great because it'll allow me to AFK it worry-free. But yeah, so wow, that's been a lot of talkery about stuff and things. I hope you guys are having fun hanging out. Got the new series, Dungeon Realms. Check it out. Leave a comment. Tell me what you think about stuff and things. And I hope that you guys have a great rest of your day. I think there's a problem.
I heard.